Sixth Sigma might sound like the title of a sci-fi movie, but it's actually a project management approach that aims to improve manufacturing processes and reduce defects. Interested in how it works? We've got you covered. The term sigma refers to the bell curve used in statistics, where one sigma represents one standard deviation in a data set. Using the Six Sigma methodology, only 3.4 errors occur per 1 million process events. In other words, if a company produces a million items, only 3.4 would have a defect, while 99.9996% of the output would be perfect. So, who came up with this brilliant approach? Well, it was initially introduced way back in the 19th century, alongside the bell curve, by Carl Friedrich Gauss. But you probably won't be surprised to hear that the initial concept was very basic and needed a lot of work. Fast forward to the mid-1980s, when Motorola was having a crisis. The company turned to Six Sigma, hoping that it would help reduce variations and problems in the manufacturing process. How successful was it? Well, the only reason you've heard of Motorola today is that the results were stunning. The quality of Motorola's products increased tremendously, encouraging other big corporations to follow suit. The main reason for Six Sigma's popularity is that it reduces the number of defects in the manufacturing process, providing businesses with a toolset for improvement. There's also a really cool connection between Six Sigma and Japanese martial arts. It's true. People's level of Six Sigma competency is rated in belts. If you have a yellow belt, that means you have a basic knowledge of Six Sigma. Theoretical knowledge plus experience in managing team-led initiatives gets you a green belt. Someone with a black belt has led at least two projects and passed the Six Sigma test. And if someone holds a master black belt, they can train and coach others. There are five important steps to Six Sigma that can be summed up in one acronym, DMAIC. Define, measure, analyze, improve, and control. In the first step, you define the problem, clearly outlining your objectives. Use numbers and real-life situations, and avoid being vague. Next, measure data to quantify the problem. Think of ways in which your products have been damaged and how bad the damage is. The next step is to take all the collected data and analyze it. Determine whether the error is just random bad luck or the result of a specific fault in your production process. After that, you should improve your process to address the problems you've detected. Gather your team, create a test, launch pilot studies, and find the most appropriate solution. The team should start building a plan and develop a timeline to implement the solution. And now for the last stage. Control. Use daily, monthly, or yearly control markers to monitor the process and avoid repeating mistakes. Six Sigma uses essential tools such as quality function deployment, fishbone diagrams, cause and effect matrices, failure models, and effects analysis. Each model has its advantages and disadvantages, and you can even use more than one model to get the desired result. You can incorporate Six Sigma in two ways. First, through a separate organization that provides services to your main business. Or secondly, by making it an integral part of every employee's job. Remember that Six Sigma focuses on the team, not the individual, no matter which approach you choose. If you do choose to use it as a team, each team member should have a certain degree of Six Sigma knowledge and expertise that fits their responsibilities. So, who should use Six Sigma? From manufacturing to transactional industries, many companies have incorporated this approach into their framework. Motorola's success with Six Sigma made it famous, but don't forget that General Electric's profits skyrocketed from $7 to $10 billion in the 5 years after it implemented this approach. But is Six Sigma right for your business and team? Well, it all depends on the industry you're in. Overall, it's a great framework that could boost your company's profits and enhance your manufacturing process. However, if you're not in manufacturing or a transactional industry, or if you do have a smaller team, a different framework might be better for you. Check out our other project management videos in the links below to see if there's a better fit. When implemented well, Six Sigma brings immense value to both companies and customers by allowing you to determine what's slowing your manufacturing process down. More importantly, it helps you eliminate delays and fix issues along the way. Have you tried Six Sigma? If so, we would love to hear more about your experience in the comments below. And while you're at it, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and share and like this video. See you soon.